You know how sometimes I'll choose an adjective for the video title that is appropriate to the subject, but a little too on the nose? Well, I did that again. Here are five depressing things about Herbert Hoover. Number one, his response to the Great Depression was weak and inadequate. Some presidencies are defined by a single crisis, and that can be a good thing or a bad thing for the legacies of those presidents, depending on how things turn out. We remember Abraham Lincoln as perhaps the greatest president in American history, but had he lost the Civil War? Well, actually, we don't need to imagine what that would have been like because we have the example of Herbert Hoover, who didn't lose a war, but who presided over the worst economic catastrophe in American history. Now, it wouldn't be fair to say that Hoover did nothing in response to the Depression. He did try a few things, but unfortunately, most of the things he tried were limited by his conviction that the Depression wasn't the government's problem to solve. He believed that private charity and self-reliance were the solutions. And when things eventually did get so bad that he tried some more direct intervention, number two, his policies may have worsened the Depression. One of the most significant pieces of legislation enacted during the Hoover administration was the Smoot-Hawley Tariff Act of 1930. The idea was to raise tariffs on imports to encourage people to buy American, while at the same time increasing revenue to the federal government. It didn't work. Other countries retaliated by raising their own tariffs on American goods, and the resulting decrease in international trade only caused the Depression to grow more severe. Hoover himself was not a fan of the Smoot-Hawley Act. He worried that it would do far more harm than good, and yet you signed it anyway, didn't you, Herbert? And you know what that means, bud? That means it's yours. It's yours forever. Number three, he embodied the myth of the businessman president. History shows that most presidents with a background primarily in business tend to be terrible, and Hoover was certainly no exception. The defining crisis of his presidency was economic in nature, yet his extensive private sector experience and business-friendly government philosophy proved to be useless at best and counterproductive at worst. But, you know, good thing the Republican Party learned its lesson and abandoned that pro-business, anti-government philosophy. Number four, he paved the way for the Southern Strategy. The Southern Strategy, that is, courting white voters through low-key racism, was crucial to electing Richard Nixon in 1968, but Hoover benefited from a very similar strategy in 1928. Running a campaign that appealed exclusively to whites while black Republicans were simultaneously removed from positions of leadership within the party. In 28, Hoover carried five southern states, which was very unusual for a Republican candidate at the time. And the Republican Party learned a very important lesson, one that it has been following with great success, especially in the South, for the last several decades. That lesson being, white supremacy works. Number five, if not for the Depression, he might not have been so bad. Yeah, the economy took a shit on his watch, but had the Depression not happened, it's likely we would remember Hoover today in much the same way we remember Calvin Coolidge. Not a great president, certainly, but not a bad one either. And in some ways, Hoover was probably an improvement over his immediate predecessors. He was far more accessible to journalists than Coolidge had been, and he was far less corrupt and more basically competent than Harding had been. He expanded the National Park Service, he directed his Justice Department to go after organized crime, he advocated for the rights of children, and he seems to have genuinely cared about eliminating poverty. Sadly, when the Depression hit, he proved to be completely unfit for that task. Sadly, for the rest of the country, I mean, not sadly for him. Because, I mean, let's not forget, you signed Smoot-Hawley, dude. You knew it was a bad bill, and you signed it anyway. I mean, what the hell was that? What could you possibly have been thinking? The hardest part is picking only five. Catch you next time. Hey folks, hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe. And also, please consider helping me to make more videos like this one by supporting this channel through Patreon. You can go to patreon.com/steveshives to become a patron. Thanks for watching.